Hi, my name is Saris Mantakap. I am the Technical Director at Software Mining. In this video, I'm going to share with you some of our experiences which has been gained from doing COBOL to Java and C# projects. But first, who is Software Mining? We specialize in COBOL to Java and C# translation tools and services. Our translations have gone into production in many government, banking and financial organizations. Our tools have been used by many system integrators to move their client applications to Java. And we have been used by software vendors to migrate their own applications to Java and C#, which is then sold and distributed to many clients. The topics I'll be covering include cost and risk associated with each of the following stages of the move to Java or C#, as well as some of the benefits of the moving to the new language. In migrating COBOL applications to Java or C#, there are two paths available: manual rewrite and automatic translation. Manual rewrite requires a new functional specification to be drawn up, then new design and architecture, and finally coding. It can produce good quality code if the project is successful, but like all large software projects, it can be a lengthy, expensive, and risky path. In automatic translation, we can produce code with 80% quality of the manual rewrite at 20% of the cost. The question becomes, if this meets the project objectives, namely maintainability, integration, enhancement, and so on, then is it justifiable to spend 5 times more to get that additional 20% quality? The biggest expense here is testing, which is influenced by accuracy and quality of the generated code. For example, when testing a batch program which generates a report, if the reports generated by the original and the new system are identical, then the test is successful. This success can be established very quickly, but if it fails, it can take quite some effort to determine the cause and fix the issue. For that reason, it pays to go for the most mature tool that you can get your hands on. Testing. The translated system only needs regression testing, which makes sure new system is generating same results as the original one. We don't need functional or unit tests because we already know the original system was correctly meeting all the business objectives and functional specifications. The first task is to produce a set of test scripts for the existing system, i.e. documenting that a given set of data and actions would produce certain results. For online applications, the actions would be the keyboard entries, results would be the material displayed on the screen or data updated in a database. For batch, the action is running the batch process, and results would be the generated reports and updated data and so on. Now, performing the same tests on the new system should produce identical results, and this is all the testing which is needed. Another thing to bear in mind is question of spot testing. Let's say we have tested 30% of the translated application and found no issues. We can then have the confidence to perform spot tests on the rest of the application. This can substantially reduce project costs. But before we start testing, we need test data. The legacy data typically resides in SQL, VSAM, or other legacy databases. When the data is already in SQL database, migration of the application becomes very easy. Both old and the new systems can access the same data, allowing testing to become easier and allowing both systems to live side by side. This means migration to COBOL C# can be achieved in small steps. For example, translate 10%, then decommission the equivalent 10% COBOL code, translate another 10%, and so on and so forth. VSAM index files. Now, not every application has this. Some already have migrated to SQL. Software Mining moves these also to SQL databases and provide utilities to facilitate various aspects of their migration, from generation of SQL schemas to conversion of EBCDIC data. Meanwhile, the Java code will access the database in an object relational design, i.e. no SQL is hard-coded in the application, which simplifies the maintenance and looking after of the code. VSAM sequential, these are usually used in reports and import-export files which are passed between the COBOL subsystems. Whilst we can migrate these to SQL, we have found it's best to keep these as is. We provide facilities for sorting, merging, and all the other activities which were provided on the original system. This allows the new Java system to continue communicating with other COBOL subsystems, i.e. you do not have to find new ways of communicating between Java and Cobol applications. Everything will work as before. Finally, some applications will use other forms of network or hierarchical databases. Most of these can be supported. The codasyl ones, again, will benefit from a very object-oriented design, which would appeal to the Java and C# developers. Now, I'm not going to go into too much detail on this one. If you have questions, please contact us. As far as the project costs are concerned, over 80% go toward testing. The implications are it would be a lot more cost efficient to go for a translation tool with good history and track record where all the issues have been identified and ironed out in previous projects. The alternative of using a newer tool with less experience can increase the workload and duration of the testing phase. This can indirectly increase project costs. You won't have to budget for it initially, but will have to go back and revise your budget at a later stage. So go for the most experienced tool that you can find. And by that I mean a COBOL to Java or C# translation tool, not a COBOL rehosting tool which has been updated last month to produce Java. In regression tests, costs can be calculated based on a number of programs. For example, in your organization with your team, it may take 2 hours to test a batch program. So 500 programs will take 1,000 hours or roughly 6 man-months or 6 developers 1 man-month to test. So you can calculate it. Also, bear in mind, half of the workload involves producing test scripts for the legacy systems. This is a useful activity in itself. It allows you to perform impact analysis after any changes or any enhancements. And let's not forget, the ability to easily perform changes and enhancements is one of the main reasons for moving to Java. Enhancements are usually performed for one of the following reasons. Moving from COBOL to Java or C# will have 2 or 3 main benefits. To start with, it will open the door to hiring new, less expensive resources. Developers who have either recently graduated or have a few years of experience under their belt. Such people want to work with Java or C#. They're not going to stay with your organization for long if forced to work in COBOL. Another benefit is moving to Java or C# opens the door to new technologies. Data mining, cloud, or simply improved productivity in data centers through use of better screen designs. Let me demonstrate. Let's take an IBM KIX or IMSDC online application. Here's an example screen. Once translated, the new screen will be JSP or ASP, but essentially an HTML screen which has to look identical to the original. In this example, we've only changed the background color to be able to differentiate between the old and the new screens. But the data entry is still going to be identical to the original and essentially the text-based. This means that no retraining will be needed for the users who can continue using the system unaffected. But at a later stage, we can use our tools to edit and redesign the screens. Here we are changing text fields and associated labels to a series of radio buttons. Now the users can use the mouse to select a valid action from the set of options instead of typing values into a text field. This is a very simple demo screen. In a real busy screen, allowing the user to select from set of valid options can reduce the number of mistypes, mistakes, and can increase the productivity of the whole system. Here's another example. The user has to fill values in 3 fields, and then a table of data is presented. The straight out of the box translation will behave in the same way. But a new look and feel can be constructed to ease data entry and for the table data to be displayed in a more clear manner. And that's the end of this presentation. I hope it has been informative. If you have any other questions, please contact us on softwaremining.com.